It is the film that has broken New Zealand box office records. Hunt for the Wilderpeople is all about this kid, foster kid Julian Dennison, on the run from police slash child services, all with the help of Sam Neill. And it is the creation of Taika Waititi, the comic genius who helped bring us a bunch of episodes of Flight of the Conchords, the brilliant vampire comedy What We Do in the Shadows, and he's just about to get set to direct the brand new Marvel movie Thor Ragnarok. So, firstly, welcome to the show.
Thanks for having us.
Yes, let's do the whole interview like that.
No, it's fine.
I'll never stop running.
Yeah, and I'll never stop chasing you. I'm relentless. I'm like the Terminator.
I'm more like Terminator than you.
I said it first, you're more like Sarah Connor. In the first movie too, before she could do chin-ups.
So you guys have broken every record for New Zealand films pretty much?
The opening weekend, we have the highest grossing opening weekend, and then we just broke the all-time box office records.
You also beat your own record as well. You beat Boy's record.
Yeah.
Kia ora, my name is Boy, and welcome to my interesting world.
How does that feel?
It's bittersweet.
Bittersweet? Why?
He lost and he won.
I prefer that other film to this one. That's good. No, I feel like... Oh, that's good. Gosh, I can stretch out.
So much easier without that guy.
Sorry, I'm coming back.
You couldn't resist the limelight that long, could you?
Yeah, nah.
For me, it's not really about the records. It's more about New Zealanders want to see New Zealand film.
His history of offences and re-offences is too long to list. We're talking graffitiing, littering, smashing stuff, burning stuff, breaking stuff, stealing stuff, throwing rocks, running away.
It's hard to get audiences along to stuff. It's probably a stigma that's stayed with us over the years of not thinking we were very cool compared to Americans.
Oh, that sounds so sad.
I'm talking about the country.
Yeah, I know you're talking about the country.
But it's still,
it's making me feel depressed.
No, I said it used to be like that.
No, it still is sort of like that.
Julian, what was your first impression of him when you first started working together?
Weird.
Has that changed at all? Is this still pretty weird?
Nah. I worked with him on an ad. It was about drug driving.
My dad gets the blazedest.
When my dad's blazed, he drives smooth as like this.
I remember it being sent on Facebook, and it's just the lips kid is what you were known as for a
while. Yeah, I would be like walking down the street or in the car, and then you could hear someone like, oh, through the lips, through the lip street, through the lips.
You hungry? That's a silly question, isn't it? Look at you.
It's weird to get you to analyse each other in front of each other, but what was it about him that you first sort of appealed to you?
He doesn't talk much.
I'm just going to move my chair. There you go, the spiller.
Doesn't like the limelight. He's not an extrovert. He sits still, he doesn't talk much. He's sort of,
I ran out of toilet paper, give me some of yours.
No.
I got to poop. I need a poop, you need a poop. We all poop.
Use a leaf.
A leaf. Oh, I hate you.
And bury it.
I'll bury you.
So I wanted to go a little bit back to the beginning. With you, there was a certain moment where you were sitting in a green room of a television production wearing a G-string, and it was a bit of a turning point for you. Can you tell us exactly what happened?
I was on this TV show called The Strip, and it was like about strippers, and I played a stripper who didn't get to strip that much.
It's like flossing your bum.
I remember just being on that show and just thinking, I don't know if I want to do this acting job for much longer, if this is the kind of thing I have to do. But it was actually that around then that I started writing films, like short films and stuff.
Your next job is a teeny tiny film in the Marvel Universe called Thor Ragnarok. I don't
just
know if you've heard of it.
Just a teeny tiny movie. Just
how do you make it interesting? Because there's so many superhero movies at the moment. There's a sort of a familiarity that it breeds where you know the third act, there's going to be major landmarks get destroyed. How do you, as somebody who's got such a unique filmic style, kind of make that interesting?
Shoot it in black and white and do it in Polish with subtitles.
Nice. You've got the lips kid too. Don't forget you can use
and put the lips kid somewhere in there.
That could be a superhero.
A voiceover by the lips kid. The way that they tend to keep things interesting is by hiring different voices, you know, different unique people who don't necessarily have any experience doing those kind of films. It's not about finding people with experience, it's about finding people who know how to tell a story.
I am attracted to the outsider, okay? That's a lot of the theme in my work is exploring this idea of people who don't belong.
Filmmakers often talk about being outsiders, and I've always kind of wondered if there's a sense of that, if you're on the outside, you're observing, and that makes you a better filmmaker, a better creative person. Does that at all hold true, or is that just one of those things?
I think it does. I think it's the same with countries, you know? Like, I feel like, you know, a New Zealand or an Australian or British, or just a foreign view of America is way more interesting than how Americans see themselves. Yeah, which is why shows like Concords worked so well, because it was from that view.
Back up, homies, and let go of my uncle!
How does it feel when you realise that you were the star of one of the biggest hits, the biggest hit in New Zealand film?
You know, it's been pretty awesome. I'm a humble guy, I'm really humble. You know, I'm not big-headed. I'm super humble, so...
Julian, Taika. This has been delightfully weird.
This has been weird.
Yeah. This has been super weird.
No, right. Comment.
Didn't they actually did this? Tell them it was the Wilderpeople.
The water people?
Guys, I'm gonna go with both your hands.
Thank you.
Nice to meet you. Okay, I'm falling over.
Awesome.
Thanks again, guys.